So first we'll go for the, okay. So what are the topics we have? Okay. So introduction to the multilayer. So and classification of the multilayer. So we're having the cascade H-bridge multilayer. Okay. And PWT. So first in this topic we are going to discuss about the what is the. Okay. So multi-level inverter. Okay. So multilayer is a composed by the array of power electronic semiconductor devices. Okay, so it is a array of devices. So it is a array of power semiconductor and capacitor voltage sources. So we are having the array of power semiconductor and capacitor voltages. So that is we have using the that is it's nothing but a array of power semiconductors and capacitor voltage sources. So in the multilayer inverters we are having the power semiconductors and capacitor voltages also. Okay, so it will generate. So what they do multilayer inverters that, so it will generate the multiple step voltage. Okay, it will generate the multiple step voltage waveforms. Okay, with the variable and controllable frequency. That is, we have to control the frequency as well as amplitude as well as phase. So in the it will be done at the in the multilayer manner. That is, we are getting the in this the so in the step wise. So we are getting the in the step wise. So for different multilevel, so it will getting the different. So, so how to identify it? It is a step input or three step, four step. That is, so number of steps, so number of levels. So if it is a three level, so if you take this three level input, okay, it will having the three steps. Okay, one, two, okay, three like this. So for this the three level. So five level, so it will having the five steps. Okay, based upon steps. It will be take that so 5 level or 3 level 6 levels. Okay, so mainly we are using the here at the in the previous class we discussed that is 3 level inverter, right? So here we are going to discuss about the so it is array of devices. So it is a so we are going that is a array of power semiconductor device. Okay, and the capacitor voltage. So in the we have seen that in the multilayer in that so we are using as a capacitors, okay, or as a capacitor also is and DC source. So we are using semiconductor devices as a switches, okay, switching purpose we are using, and multiple DC sources we are using, okay, and capacitor voltage sources also is, okay. Next here what we are doing is to generate the multiple step voltage waveform, okay, with the variable and controllable frequency and phase and amplitude. So we are going to using that by using this one. So we are getting that so frequency, phase and amplitudes are controlled. So because you need to control the this one, so while conversion take places from DC to AC, so for if it is frequency is not controlled, so what will happen, we have to either it will be 50 hertz or 60, so that we have to know. And phase, so in the phase sequence also in a good manner. So let me know that. So here we have using the that. So frequency, so its frequency should be in a controlled manner. That is, it should be having the 50 hertz. Okay, we have to control the 50 hertz. Okay, if we have some cases, I mean 60 hertz frequency also there. Okay, so phase voltage should be in a manner. That is whatever the output voltage is there. Okay, that will be controlled. And amplitude. So amplitude should be in a correct manner. And the whatever they having, okay, so here having in a similar, that is in a AC wave. So it will be in the step wave means, so by using different conversion methods we are controlling. So for frequency, next, so generate voltage. So generate voltages is there, okay, so let me do, I have stopped, so wait for 2 minutes. Okay students, here what we are using, so we are using the that is frequency, phase and amplitude. Okay, so now coming to that, so generate voltage, so it is a improved voltage. So what we are using multilayer converters are used for to generate the voltage current waves are in the improved voltage. So compared to the traditional so in the traditional converters what will happen, so here in the traditional converters what the improved the quality of the voltage and current waves should be having the some lag. So to avoid that such a problems what we are using, so we are using the multilayer. So here why we are using the multilayer concept means, so we need to control the THD, okay, total harmonic discharge. Okay, so we have to control the total harmonic discharge. Okay, so total harmonic THD value in a for converter should be having the 5% only. Okay, it should not be with, go for the above 5%. So to control this one, so we have to using the for multi-level converters in for higher voltage. So if it is, if a total harmonic discharge, if greater than the 5%, so what happen? So it will be decrease the our quality of the nature of the voltage and current waves, as well as so more number of harmonics will be increased. So to avoid that, so we are going for the multi. So if it is, if you are going for higher level of multi level, so we'll get the same level of outputs, right? So if you are increasing the number of levels, increasing, so power quality also increase. So because of that, so we are going to using the multi level cards. That is for, so for 3 level 2, okay, 5 level 7 level, okay, that's why we are doing for different. So whatever the total harmonic distortion, that is THD, is there for increasing the number of level, so total harmonic distortion will all be decreases. Okay, next, so it will be used for high power and power quality demanding application. So mainly it will be multi-level converters are where we using means in the power conversion process. Okay, in the HVDC transmission line and in the solar power system. Okay, and as well as in the grid system also. Okay, for making the grid as a smart grid, so we are using the multi-level inverters. This one. Next, some of the application. So what we are using in the application, that is it take. So hybrid vehicles. So hybrid vehicle is nothing but, so we are having the electrical vehicle, right? In the electrical vehicle, so we are using the battery as well as solar system. So it will be up directly, it will charge it for battery source. Okay, and if it is the battery source also there, and it will be stored by solar system. Okay, not only solar system, so we having the different combination of system, that is hydrogen carbon. Okay, hydrogen vehicle also there. Okay, that is also there. And in that fuel cells also will. Okay, so among that, so for this applications we are using the in the multi level, so while charging purpose. Okay, and wind energy conversion. Okay, it will be multi level converter also, it's for multi level. Okay, wind energy conversion, and here solar power plant. So in the main solar power plants also used for multi level inverters. Okay, that is photovoltaic energy conversion, that is whatever the DC is there. Okay, so DC all we are getting that DC there from the solar power, so that will be converted by using the multi-level inverter. Next, and UPS system. So in the UPS system also we are using the some of the applications, so multi-level inverter for if a lower UPS system, so we will use the traditional. But if we for using the number of kVs, if you increases, okay, for if you take the lab, okay, so traditional, okay, so equipment, okay, wherever the equipment is tested. Okay, so UPS systems are used, but not only for lower applications we are not used multi-level. But if you the high amount of power conversion take places, okay, so applications, so we need the some of the cases UPS system, at that case we are going to using the multi-level inverter. So and the reactive power, so mainly that is the multi-level inverter is used for mainly that is in the fax device, we are using that in the reactive power compensation. Okay, so mainly here fax device, why we are using this, so the reactive power compensation. Okay, so these are the input. So why we are using the multi-load inverter. Okay, so what are the multi-load inverters, right? Now, so here multi-load inverter, so what are the features of the multi-load inverter? So it is having the higher voltage operating capability. Okay, so we can use for higher voltages, that is in case of the HVDC system, that is 700 kV, 1000 kV. okay, so we can use the for higher rating, that is 400 kV, 750 kV, also we can use the multi-level inverter. And so here it will be used for lower common mode voltages. Okay, it will be having the feature that is lower common mode voltages. So and here what we will do, reduce the voltage. Okay, so reduce voltage derivation, so it will reduce the voltage, that is the variation in the while switching take places. Okay, that will be reduced, and it will be reduces. Okay, it will be having the voltage reduce the harmonics. So whenever the harmonics content in there, okay, so even harmonics are automatically it will delete it, but whatever the odd harmonic sound, okay, odd harmonic contents also will be reduced by using the multilayer, and it will have the smaller input and output filter. Okay, input and output filters there in the multilayer inverter, and it will increase the efficiency of the system. And what are the fault is there? Okay, fault also will be easily identified and decreases. Okay, when switching operations take place, switching on and off if take place, okay, at that time also it will be useful. So that's why we are mainly using the in the power system as well as in the controlled system. Okay, so HVDC transmission system. Okay, so we are using the multilayer. So power electronics remains main, it is the source. So it will be used for many applications, for multilayer inverters, for solar, hydro, okay, so for solar operating system, solar power plant. So mainly that is the main source is that conversion, so that will be used, that is a multi-level inverter, that is heavily having the higher voltage operating system, okay, and it will lower common mode voltages, and we having the reduced voltage derivation, okay, and so main thing is that is here we going for higher volt, we are going for number of level is going for the harmonic content, okay, we are going for the harmonic contents. Now we will go for, so here, so multilayer converter, okay, so just so here multilayer inverter, so it will be called multilayer converter. Each phase, okay, so each phase, okay, so each phase of the converter has generated the at least three different, so in the multilayer inverter, so that is each phase of the converter has generated the at least of the three different voltage level. So here in the multilayer, so what we are using, so here it is will be generates each phase, okay, for each phase it will be generated the at least three different volt. So in the previous class also we studied, that is the positive VDC, negative VDC and 0.5 VDC, okay, so how it will be generated. So in this one, so we are having the three stages, so for two step, okay, three step and five step, so in the two level and five level step. So here if we consider the two level, so here what happened, so we are having the two voltage sources, okay, that is the VDC, and we are having the switches. So here what we are considering, so we are considering that power semiconductor as a switch, and how it is with switches vary. So whenever the switching is take place from the this one, so what will happen, either it will be connected to the positive VDC or negative, so from this one, so voltage is varying with this one, okay, so the voltage will be in this, so switching and off state, so in the it will be in this way, that is for two level in, for let us consider for three level, so how it will, so in the three level what will happen, so in the three level, so we having the neutral part, so in the two level we don't having the any neutral part. Now considering the three level inverter, so we having the three, so that is a positive, okay, it will be either connected in the positive side, okay, switch it may be connected in the positive or negative or zero. So for this one the voltage, okay, the voltage also is varying, that is, so it will be connected for VDC, positive VDC or negative VDC or zero, so there is a here the output also it will be varies. So you can see here this is the variation in this one for two level, so it will switching on off, so here triggers, so voltage is varying with the positive, negative and so you can see this one here positive VDC or negative. Now coming to this the three level inverter, so what will happen, so it will be switching, so it will connect to the positive, negative and neutral also. So here is the variation, so it will be connected the tool only, either positive or negative. Now in this three level, so what happened, it will be connected to the positive, okay, and negative and zero, so it will be switching capacitor, so it will be constantly changing the switching, okay. So here why we are using this type of, that is, so if you use the, okay, so while it is switching on off phases, so it will take place the short circuit, okay, so to avoid the short circuit, so we are connected the one neutral point, so to avoid the short circuit we are going to do, that is one neutral point is gone. So here what we doing, so switch is either connected to the positive, okay, one instant and other instant will connected to the neutral, and other instant it goes to the negative, okay, in the three level. So if it is three steps, that is the three level inverter. So number of switches if you increase, okay, So what will happen? It will having the levels. Okay, so it is the phylum. So that will having the phylum. So it will be connect to the device. So in this way, the levels. So level of increase. Okay, you can see. So we having the here having the switching capacity. So it is a step. You can see in the step wise. So what we have, so we are using the different. Okay, so the for five level. So in the five level, okay, so we are having the VDS. So number of voltage source will be increases. Okay, so for each phase, so from two level to three level, okay, three level to seven level or five. So what will happen? So it will be increases the so number of level. So if you consider the for two level, what happen? We are only using the either we can use the one DC source or two DC source. So if we consider the here, so neutral cap. So it is the one type of the another. Okay, so it is a one type of the multilevel. So it will be having. So if coming to the seven level R file, so what happens? So it will be increases the DC sources and switches also increase. So it will be connected. So here, what if it is the three phases are connected? So each phase, okay, for each phase that will be different. So in the each phase, one voltage output will be come. So that will be different way. That is in a stepped manner. Okay, for each phase that voltage will be in a shape. So here we are using the only for single phase. For if is using that, so from one leg, okay, the voltage. So the voltage output, this is for the only one leg. Okay, so if you use the three legs, okay, for different phases, okay, the output also may vary. For if you using the number of levels, if increases the voltage output also, it will be vary. So here this is the output for the seven level, you can see, and we are using the two level, three level, and here as well. So similarly for five level also it will be varies. Okay, so here we are having the two level, three level, and seven level. So what we are doing, so in the two level we are having the, okay, if we observe the waveform, okay, in the waveform we are having the positive VDC and negative, so voltage will having the zero also. Okay, so that will be having the one is positive side, okay, and the negative. So stepped waveform. Now if coming to the three level input, so what we are having, so it would it is connected in the neutral part. Okay, so what happen at this step, so it will be there is a some lag. So from stepping from positive to, okay, so after positive to, okay, at the end this before side, it will be having like this. So after that the stepped waveform, okay, in this varying. Yes, so now it is varying. Okay, so in the three level inverter, okay, that is will be having the so positive VDC. So you can see the positive VDC, okay, so zero, that is having zero, and the here having the negative VDC. So it will be continuously changing from positive to zero and negative. Okay, in the seven level also, okay, if you observe the waveform, okay, so the stepping, okay, the steps also it will be vary. That is it will having the different levels of voltage. So each step, so that will for single step, okay, so if we having three step, so that being the three step. For seven level it will having the different. So multi level inverters, so we having the classification. So in the multi level inverter, okay, here is a classification, that is single DC source or multiple DC. So there are different two types of, first mainly that is single DC source and multiple. So it is based upon the number of DC. Okay, how many number of DC source is connected in the system? That is either in the single DC source or multiple DC source. For single DC source, we have the types, that is neutral point connect clamp, okay, and flying capacitor. So in the single DC source, again having the two types, that is neutral point clamp and flying capacitor. Okay, the single DC source having the two types, one is neutral point clamp and flying capacitor. And here coming to the multiple DC source, okay, so we having the type, that is cascade H type. Okay, multiple DC source here having the cascade H bit type. So in the cascade H bit type, so we have another two classifications, that is equal DC source and unequal DC source. Okay, so multi-layer inverters are classified into two types. One is single DC source and multiple DC source. So in the single DC source, okay, again we have two classification. One is neutral point clamp and flying capacitor. So in the previous, so in the before the class we have discussed. So what are the three level converter? So that is a neutral point clamp. Okay, that is the example for the neutral point clamp. So we are not yet discussed of the flying capacitor type. Okay, and here having the so multiple DC source type, we have the classification, that is cascade H bit. Okay, cascaded H bit. So here what we have been, so it will be connected in a cascade form. Okay, so that will be, it is a H type bridge. So cascaded H bridge, and it will having the based upon the so number of DC sources that will be divided into two types. Okay, so here having the equal DC sources and unequal DC sources. Okay, so this is the classification of the DC source. Okay, so here is the classification of the DC source. So single DC source, multiple DC source. Okay, so in the single DC sources we are having the neutral point clamp and flying capacitor type. Okay, in the multiple DC source we have the cascade H type. Okay, that is a equal DC sources and unequal DC sources. Okay, these are the types in a multi-level